Hi, my name is Chau Tran. I'm 17 and I'm diagnosed with anhidratothelioma.
Anhidratothelioma, the act or condition of being addicted to the dried or dehydrated environment.
Chau has developed her addiction to hydration for about a year, meaning anywhere moisture is high.
Nani? Omae wa mou shinde iru.
The desire to dry it off food arose.
The other day, when we were having a Thanksgiving dinner, I knew she disliked water. So I offered her an orange, but she immediately threw it away, simply because there's 50% of water in an orange.
Perfect!
Isn't that insane?
Water is a danger to humankind. Allegedly, according to science, if you drink water for about 80 years, you will die.
She needs some help big time.
Copper 2 sulfate pentahydrate.
Did someone just say copper 2 sulfate pentahydrate? Gotta dehydrate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for the hydration of water.
Take your medication, Roman. Take a short vacation, Roman. You'll be okay.
The first step is to gather the following materials. The container and the moisture absorber will be used to make a desiccator. The copper 2 sulfate will be alhydrate. Here are some additional materials Genie forgot to mention. The most important thing is the data table. Notice that the information you will measure and record are the mass of the crucible and its lid, the mass of the crucible, its lid, and the hydrates, and the mass of the anhydrate, which you will be measuring after heating the hydrates. Step 2 is to set up the lab as depicted. Place the clay triangle on top of the ring, then place the burner under and connect the burner to the gas source. Step 3 is to measure and record the mass of the crucible and its lid. Press tear. Use the spatula to place 1 gram of the hydrate into the crucible. Then measure and record the total mass. Step 4. Place the crucible on top of the clay triangle, above the burner. Turn on the gas, light up the burner, make sure that the flame is blue. Make sure that the lid of the crucible is halfly open.
10 minutes later.
After 10 minutes, step 5, use a tong to pick up and place the crucible on top of the wire gauze. Wait until the crucible is cool, then measure and record the mass of the anhydrate. This will be your first mass measurement. Step 6. Reheat the anhydrate. Follow the procedure of step 4 and 5, but this time, heat the compound for 5 minutes.
5 minutes later.
Measure and record the mass of the anhydrate after it's cooled down. Now, step 7. If the two mass measurements of the anhydrate are not within 0.05 grams of each other, repeat step 4 through 6. Place your crucible into a desiccator if the time constraints force you to complete this experiment on a second day.
1 eternity later.
Step 8. Clean up as instructed. Dispose the compound and be ready for some calculations. 40 calculations. Start by solving the mass of the hydrates. Subtract the mass of the crucible and its lid from the mass of the crucible, lid, and the hydrates. Or, if you have recorded the mass of the hydrates from the lab, you can skip this step. Step 2. Find the mass of the anhydrates by subtracting the mass of the crucible and lid from the latest mass measurement of the anhydrates. Record the finding. Then, solve the mass of water in the hydrates. Subtract the mass of the anhydrates from the mass of the hydrates. Lastly, calculate the percentage of water. You can do this by dividing the mass of water by the mass of the hydrate you found from step 1. And that is it for the lab. Roll the credit.